What's up, guys? So, around this time last night, I played this game for the first time in about 10 years, and I beat the easy game. So now I'm gonna see if I can, do the ones a little bit harder. Oh, let me try to fix that. Is that better?
Good luck.
Cool, thank you. So fans of the newer games might recall certain tropes that might have been carried over, like Slippy getting into trouble with enemies all the time. Results from playing this on an emulator makes it a bit tricky to play. On top of this being a pretty laggy game to begin with, because of the 3D format of the system. From holding down the boost button the entire time.
Incoming enemy.
So this guy is an upgraded form of the boss from course 1 in this game. And you may recognize him as the non-secret boss from Corneria, the first stage in Star Fox 64. They reused a bunch of SNES Star Fox stuff in 64. Quality voice acting.
Good luck.
Space stage is my favorite because you get this targeting reticle, and it runs more smoothly because there are no like buildings or things to draw on the ground. It's just this planet thing. Similar mechanic as future games. There are three levels in this game as well. And this is a shield, which makes you take no damage from, I think, three hits. So instead, this made a return in Star Fox Zero. If you go too far to the left or right in an attempt to dodge these things, the game sends these orbs after you that fire plasma balls. This is I actually had a practice run of this course earlier in the day that I was able to do deathless. And I was really proud of myself. And in retrospect, maybe that may have just been dumb luck. Wow, I don't think I could have crashed into more of those things. I did a full playthrough of the easy course. Boss, if you want to check it out. It's like 1 or 2 of my mods. I think I'm going to try to do this one, and then after this one, the hardest one, Course 3. I've never actually beaten Course 3, personally. So if I do that, I will have restored my Star Fox skill beyond its childhood. So Titania, I think they have in both 64 and Assault. It's probably one of my favorite stages in this game. Because it starts out with this like snowy weather. Go through it as many times as you want, in case you you want to upgrade your lasers to the most powerful versions, which I've decided that I want to do. Some enemies in this game, like that one, who don't spawn in until after they've already fired their, like, projectile at you, because of what I'm assuming is the very limited draw distance of all the polygons in this game. This looks really neat. This is maybe my favorite piece of, like, scenery for the game. Cracker Jack timing for this guy, because if he does that, you gotta dodge it while shooting him. Finally. So even though it seemed like the last stage was pretty brutal because I lost all but one of my lives to it, all the stages that are remaining in this course of the game are actually, in my opinion, the most brutal because of the bosses in them. So this level has a gimmick, and the gimmick is these things that are flying around that are sort of like organic space life. And by default, most of them are hostile. And if you shoot them enough times, they change color and they sort of go away. But every now and then, because again, it's a troll game, they throw one at you that's in peaceful mode, and shooting it turns it hostile. And then it rams into you and kills you. Like that one. It's blue. They ram into you. They wanted to showcase what a useful teammate Sippy is. So they scripted that event just for him, where he kills an enemy. Real proud of you, Slip. So you cannot damage your own teammates, in contrast to future entries in the franchise. So they just get in the way of you shooting the enemies. Yep, that's a hostile one. So this guy is quite hard. And his gimmick is to take his arms out first. Dodging them, and everything else that he is shooting.
Let's go.
Is this what they call the streamer's curse? You do a perfect run in practice and then this happens during stream. Is that what that is? Space whale, and you get him if you kill either certain enemies or a bunch of enemies that come before him. So he drops lots of goodies, like you'll notice that he gave me shields and some bombs, and he upgraded my blasters. And that, I think, is this game taking pity on you for having to fight this boss. So maybe the whale comes if you 100% the level, which I apparently did. So the penultimate level here is Venom in orbit. Level-wise, it's maybe easier than the previous one. But the boss is, as I said before, very nasty. Being a dick also starts with this game. So that was a thing from the very beginning. Violent image for this game, that like alien pilot guy flying out into the cold vacuum of space after his spacecraft was destroyed. And oh great, I lost a wing. So same mechanics as in other installments of the franchise, you lose a wing, you lose all your laser upgrades. So this boss is also really hard. A recurring theme with this boss, the previous boss, and the one that comes next, if I get to him, is their physical bosses. The bulk of their damage comes from them, like, basically ramming you, not like with other enemies and bosses who, like, shoot projectiles at you. This is gonna be a clutch if anything. Oh boy. No clutch. Thank you. so that guy right there, he drops a shield. And I want to kill him in a place where I'd be able to get to the shield, unlike last time. That shield will help me survive the boss. Is he gone? He's gone. Motherfucker.
Incoming enemy.
So what I'm doing with the Nova Bombs there is, there are these little pieces of debris in between these two parts, and it's really hard to both kill them with your lasers while you're busy dodging and crushing you. This guy, you only need to do 50% damage to. If one of the halves dies, the boss dies. So just a couple of markets here. Yeah. Astute viewers may notice that there was a little escape pod that escaped down to the planet. So we'll be seeing the remains of this guy again. And he will be using similar tactics against us. Straight into the wall without me touching him. It evokes, like, a feeling of desperation, is my interpretation, in the enemy forces to stop me. Like, I've gotten this far, so their level of organization in trying to defeat me is, like, non-existent. Just throwing everything they have at me. So this is... aliens on, like, space motorcycles trying to ram me to death. What you have to do is slow down and try not to get hit by them, and then shoot them out of the sky. Like so.
Incoming enemy.
And here comes the boss. What he's gonna do is open up and release another pair of these guys. And then try to squeeze you into the wall. And much like with the last boss, you have to be really crackerjack in your timing with your slowdowns and maneuvering. And I sort of expected that. Oh, and this was our last life. This is gonna be close either way. But I think the fact that I now have 3 Nova Bombs, whereas I had like 1 last time, is gonna help me out. I think as soon as he opens up to release those Rider guys, I'm gonna just nuke them immediately. And then focus on dodging. I think I can get him. Die, it's still a game over, and I'm out of credits, so I need to get to Andross and kill him on this life. Yeah, thanks, Otterpus. I don't know if you were here earlier, but I wasted like 6 lives getting here. It went way, way worse than the stream I did of this yesterday. Alright, so I think I'm gonna play safe here. Yeah, that was me. So So there are three courses in this game, and a course is basically a set of like levels that you go through. And they're in order of increasing difficulty from 1 to 3. So yesterday I played course 1, which is like the easy course. Which even after like 10 years of not playing this game, I can do pretty reliably. So this is course 2, which is the moderate difficulty one. And I'm scrolling. And course 3, the hard one, I've never beat. Maybe that'll be my version of KY's Tower Climb Legend Fragment Run, if I ever manage to do it. Yes, so yesterday, with the easy mode version of this, I only had to go through one cycle of destroying that base and shooting this thing. But in the intermediate mode, it's two cycles, and in hard mode, I think it's three. But anyway, we beat him, and we beat the game on intermediate mode by the skin of our teeth. That is a different game than Star Fox 64, and they run left. Although we get to hear that awesome voice acting again. Oh yeah, well, in any case, they don't run anywhere. I think that would have exhausted the, like, 2 megabits of memory that this card has. I think they spent a good chunk of it on that voice clip there. I was actually amazed when I was playing this in, like, 1984, and I beat it for the first time. Wow, there's, like, actual voice acting in a Super Nintendo game. It was previously unheard of. Series. It's maybe my favorite video game franchise. I'm a little biased because I got to be pretty good in all of them. And, I guess you enjoy getting more if you're good at it. Look at this. Three guys programmed this entire game. Just three guys. Yeah, you had to be awesome to write game code back in the day. There was no, like, sugar-coated Unity engines and stuff. You had to, like, write machine code for the hardware. The music still finishes a little early, and this is with SNES 9X as opposed to ZSNES. So like all the emulators I've tried have this problem. Alright, I think that's it for this time. In a future stream, I think I'll do the two Easter eggs they have in this game, the black hole and the other dimension. And then after that, maybe I'll try to do course 3, which would be a first time for me ever. Alright, thanks for watching, thanks for the follows. Everyone have a good night, morning, afternoon, whatever time it is where you are. Take care.